So when a patient comes to get a vaccine, what they're getting is a modified version of that pathogen that is not able to cause disease, but is able to teach the immune system how to respond to that potential pathogen.
But that doesn't work for HIV.
Or some of the more difficult to make vaccines.
So we tried that for 25 years and we just really did not see any efficacy in doing it that way.
We realized that we needed to guide the immune system to make the right kind of antibodies.
And that's what the Duke Human Vaccine Institute has really championed, taking the natural immune system, studying it at the most basic level, and then working through the vaccine life cycle to create a product that will recreate that in all individuals.
My lab contributes to the research and discovery component. We make vaccines directly in our group, and we can give them to the structural biology team and Prima Vada Acharya. She can tell us why the antibodies are ineffective, and she does this with cryo-EM using the Titan Krios.
So this is a TEM, a transmission electron microscope, and from that we learn atomic level details, and then using that we hope to make a vaccine.
In December 2019, we published a study in Science that showed that we were able to design vaccine components that could actually carry us through the first initial stages of developing an effective HIV vaccine.
What do you mean, what I feel? It's just a machine.
I mean, no, but you seem to have a connection to this machine.
Yeah, but the connection is through the computer.
This was the aha moment. We realized that if we could do this with the HIV vaccine, that we might be able to generally engineer the immune system. We came up with what's called the Immune Resiliency Initiative. This fits into an overall new initiative of the university called the Science and Technology Initiative.
And so it is a massive team science type of endeavor.
Pharmaceutical companies may not be ready to work on these kinds of problems, but we believe that it's the responsibility of academic institutions to be able to do this.
Research and discovery, preclinical testing, GMP manufacturing, we've been able to bring all of those different steps in-house.
We believe that this is a blueprint now for many of the other more difficult to make vaccines that we've struggled with for 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 years.
HIV.
It's lupus or rheumatoid arthritis.
It's congenital cytomegalovirus.
Neurodegenerative diseases. Cancers.
The flu virus.
Cardiovascular diseases. Duke has been a wonderful environment for this work, and it's a real tribute to the people.
It's motivation that tells us to keep pushing down that road.
It's exciting to have that potential impact.
The concept of global access, or making these vaccines available to those that need them, is central to our philosophy at the Duke Human Vaccine Institute.